Climate change has impacts on everything. Everything you care about, climate change will be impacting now and even more into the future.
The scientists have predicted that if we allow climate change to continue as it is through to the end of the century, we could lose one or two in every five of the species that live on our planet. And Australia is particularly vulnerable. You know, we are one of eight mega diverse regions on Earth in terms of species diversity. We are also a very ancient continent, and many of our species have tiny little distributions. And with this change in the metabolism of our planet, their last refuges are becoming not tenable for them. No species can't exist there any longer. So we can anticipate that if things continue, Australia will probably have a higher rate of species loss than many other parts of the planet.
One of the big concerns we have is coral reefs globally. As the oceans are warming, we're seeing coral bleaching events where we're losing large amounts of intact reef. From in terms of the Amazon and other tropical forests, as we see rainfall patterns change and warming, these systems could actually go into a form of collapse. The Amazon recycles a lot of its rainfall, so what happens is the trees die, the moisture that's put back in the atmosphere gets cut off. So we change the whole rainfall patterns of large areas like the Amazon or the Congo. And when that happens, we can't actually sustain the tropical forests anymore. These are big areas of collapse we're concerned about.
The other thing is, climate change is changing the length of seasons. So spring, if we have a spring, spring is going to be a bit earlier in the year and it may be shorter in duration. And this may have an effect on the flowering of plants. And many plants are pollinated by insects. So the problem that we are foreseeing is that the insects may not be around when the plants need them. So we talk about this decoupling of ecological phenomena like pollination of plants.
And with climate change, with Australia getting hotter, even within New South Wales, we are getting hotter each year. We have mosquito-borne illnesses. And we have people who travel. We have the most travelled nation, Australia, which has the potential of bringing more illnesses than mosquito-borne within Australia. There is a worldwide problem with dengue fever. We have malaria. These are potential illnesses we could have in the southern part of this country because of our climate and air travel.
The two main impacts that I've felt already are water security. So we're in the middle of November and we're already starting to see water shortages here. And also, obviously, the increase in temperature. It's supposed to be 32 or 33 degrees here today in Crookwell. In the middle of November, that is extraordinary. I hate to think what it'll be like in January, February, March, which are the hottest months of the year for us.
There are changes in terms of like the weather patterns that affect the food that we grow, like in the garden, because people like in the rural area, especially Solomon Island, we live on our land and food, and so that is how we survive. We depend on the natural environment, and so we started to notice that there's some changes on the food that we grow, sometimes because of too many rains, you know, we don't have like good crops. It affecting the crops that we grow. And sometimes we expect that we will have, you know, sun for a long time, dry season, but it changes. So you cannot predict the weather. And so that's how it is affecting a lot of the food crops, a lot of the plants and animals that we have, you know, in our environment and also in our ecosystem.
Australia is surrounded by other mega diverse islands. So New Caledonia, the Solomon Islands, Papua New Guinea, all of those areas have exceptional ancient biodiversity, and all of them are very, very vulnerable to climate change.
Many of the communities, they live on the coast. And so some of the islands that they live, like on atoll islands, like in Malaita, some villages and the houses that they built before have now been washed away by sea. And like village, places where village used to stay, only people where people used to live before has been washed away. And so people have to move to another location, and that causes another trouble. Like if you don't have any land, like, you know, that also causes a social problem, and also causes, you know, psychological problem to people who are living on the coast. And so that is one of the examples how the impact of climate change, you know, affect mostly people who are living on the coast.
We as Wiradjuri and Waiwan people, within our cultural belief system, we see every living thing as our kin, which is our family. So the river is our family, the rocks are our family, the mountains are our family, the trees, the plants, the lizards, the spiders, all the furry and fluffy cute animals, everything's our family. And that causes me deep heartache to know that all those different species of plants and animals are also affected by either lack of water, heat, destruction of their environments, lack of rivers and creeks flowing and springs drying up and so forth, the different effects that we see in Australia at the moment from climate change and all the fires.
The impacts of climate change are definitely significant, with bushfires just spreading across Australia in itself like we've never seen before, and our First Nations people are being affected by fracking, and just people in coastal areas and even those in suburban areas are definitely being affected on greater levels.
We know that if a community is actually prepared for an emergency, a climate emergency, they actually cope better with it. At this point in time, our population is not prepared for the potential disasters that can occur with climate change, with the increased risk of flooding, with the increased fires, with increased heat waves. Our population is not prepared.
The bushfires in 2019 are one of the things that I imagine is my worst nightmare, because I never expected Australia to face it in such a harsh and significant way. They've been just spreading across our country, and yeah, I can only imagine it getting worse if we don't take action now.
Here in Australia, through the summer of 2019-2020, we saw an extraordinary fire event that without action would have caused the extinction of species like the Wollumai pine. They were just protected by human action. We are yet to see what the full impacts of that fire will be. You know, an area almost the size of England was burned through those fires. 33 lives were lost, over 2,000 houses burned. These are unprecedented conditions. And they arose because we had the hottest year on record by a long margin, 2019. It was also the driest year on record. And before it was the driest year on record for the Murray-Darling Basin. So the country just dried out, heated up, and we had this catastrophic event. In terms of what was actually responsible for those conditions, it's really clear that human-caused climate change had a big influence.
Solastalgia is the homesickness you get when the world around you is changing.
We, the people in the Pacific, are the most affected people. And I think we need to realize that the impact of climate change is real and is affecting a lot of people, especially in the Pacific, who live in atoll islands and also on the coastal, you know. It's a real thing, and it's affecting a lot of people, and it will continue to happen. And so we need to take some actions and also work together.
Climate change is impacting biodiversity, coral reefs, the lengths of seasons, water security and weather patterns. The impact of climate change is real. We need to take action and work together.